A stranger lost in this city. Where do you go? A stranger lost in this city. What do you know? You know.
Of antiquity. I know I've lived thousands and thousands of lives. I feel those lives like dreams all bubbling underneath me all the time. And in some of those lives I was a musician, in some of those lives I was a singer. And in none of those lives, about 300 BC, I lived in Alexandria with my twin sister, Aliki. Aliki was studying to be an astronomer. But I had married her off to a man from mainland Greece. And now she'd run away. With all of its money and slaves. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's not easy being the Emperor of Rome. All those senators, all those soldiers, all those Britons, all those Germans, all those Africans, all those Greeks, all those senators, all those plebeians, all those charioteers, all those gladiators. Sometimes I wish all of Rome had just one neck. Feedback happening here. That's got to stop. Whatever.
My mother screamed my name inside her dream. My brother dreamed he'd kill me, but he killed me. Sometimes I feel so bad.
I tried my best for everybody. Thank you so much. Sorry, everybody, people watching overseas. Whatever that sound is has to stop right now. Whatever the fuck it is, it's just driving me crazy. Is the bass up too loud in the monitors, or what is it? I turn it right down then, because it's just like this note coming up. It was very hard when you grew up in a civilization that had 2,444 gods and goddesses. And every tree had a spirit, and every river had a spirit, and the sea had spirits. All the elements had spirits, everything had a spirit. Everything was a god, or a demigod, or a nymph, or a naiad, or a dryad, or a... So we pray. company from the north march on tired heels through fires and mires and ambushes pushing through the fields. Birds of ill omen fill the air. I can feel the presence of some devil working there. So we pray, so we pray, so we pray. The arrows of the Prince of Light, so tipped with death. I can feel him loose at whatever's on me left. So we pray, so we pray, so we pray, so we pray. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. I'm just going to practice my bass riff here quickly, Gareth. Dreams are everything in the ancient world. One morning I dreamt I saw an eagle in the sky. In its claws, it held a wolf cub. And a voice in my head said, now the eagle will drop the wolf cub, and the child that catches the cub will be the Emperor of Rome. A terrible blessing has come into my life. The enchantress the dream of a curious man foretelling the plague. I walk in the shadows, seven moons in the sky. You know, King Peleus was sailing across the Aegean Sea one day on his way to Ithaca to visit his friend, who was King Odysseus's father. And he looked into the sea and he saw the most beautiful woman he'd ever seen. In the sea, she had popped up, and she was the Nereid, and her name was Thetis. And King Peleus pushed all his men away and he dove into the Aegean Sea, into the wine-dark sea. Those long-haired Aegeans on their black-beaked ships sailing, gliding over the wine-dark sea. And he dove into the water to find the Nereid, the sea nymph, the immortal nymph. And they met up in a cave. And they knew each other well. And 9 months later, the Nereid appeared with a boy she had dipped in the river Styx, held onto by his heel. And she gave him to the king. And she said, "This is your son. And his name is Achilles."
Change her mind.
Thank you. There was a man near Jerusalem who'd been cast out of society. He wandered in the wilderness, and one day Jesus came. Jesus met him, and Jesus followed, said, don't talk to that man, he's mad. He's a madman. And Jesus met the man and said, he could see he was possessed. He said, what is your name? And a voice answered, our name is Legion. And Jesus cast all of those devils out. And they jumped into a flock of swine who were grazing near the river. And the swine went mad and dived into the river and drowned. This song is called A Devil. After the last great slavery, the last slave rebellion in Rome, led by the now famous Spartacus, the Romans crucified 8 miles of slaves all the way into Rome for 8 miles. They were crucified slaves all the way in, just to show you what happened if you fucked with the empire. Myself and my friend Trimalchio escaped. We now wander in the country called Canaan, wandering and condemned. Thank you. The afterlife is full of the whispers of salvation. Gilgamesh takes off his armor in the halls of Montezuma. Servants of the tyrant are all fucking in the garden. The empire all stretched thin, right down to the Mediterranean. Egyptian quack who cured you was thrown into a dungeon. The brutal thrust of a scimitar or the scar of a surgeon. Burns on in the troubled sky, right down to the horizon. And the Tigris River bursts her banks just short of Armageddon. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Sweet benediction. not alone. The leaves are whispering under your. I'm just a poor man here. Death comes to everyone, conqueror or king. Listen down the wind, old jackals sing. All the jackals sing. Thank you. Before Gareth and I went ancient, we were merely medieval. We were just medieval guys hanging out. And I don't know, it's a beautiful song called Ophelia Without Wine.
Christina with a snow and I, oh.
This song's called The Fatal Hour. We're dying to play it to you. The fatal hour still sound in its cage, and fools come out to promenade around the holiday.
And every silver son of a bitch keeps falling down
over my head. Spake the snake, he said, I wish I had a leg to bring, and all the clowns could appreciate their cage.
For every one golden god, there is 10 million lumps of clay.
I'm back in the dark, we'll have a nice day.
Thank you.
Almost 2,000 years ago, when I was still a child, my father took me before the altar of the goddess Ishtar. When I was 7 years old, in the place where they had the sacrifices, I looked upon the goddess and she appeared to me. The goddess Ishtar, with two snakes, two lions, and two owls that hovered around all the time. My father said, "Swear to the goddess, Rome will be your enemy forever." And she looked at me, and I swore. This is a prayer to my lady Ishtar.
Listen to me.
Thank you. We've got one more. There was a civilization we don't even know the name of. It existed thousands and thousands of years ago. And there's almost nothing left of them except one poem. And the poem says and reiterates, and cries out and says, we will be remembered. We will be remembered. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Good night. Thank you.